Well, I'm just going to annealing my gaskets. Two rocker gaskets and a head gasket. Right, I'm going to use the old head gasket, just anneal that one. And then I made these a while ago. I couldn't eat them up a bit, but they work as they are. I'm just going to anneal them. So, I don't separate myself. Stage one. Nice. Right, I'll go in here and clean them up. Basically get the slag off them. So. Nice and soft now then. Just stab myself in the thumb. Man, they are soft. Them are really thin, them. But that was quite hot, quite thick. Handy piece of laminate flooring. I'm just going to use one of them stainless steel pan scrubbers. Yap, 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 I see what you mean. Let's shut the door, see if I can quiet it down a bit. Oh, no bloody difference. Hopefully I'll be able to edit out the yappy bits. I'll explain why I've made them like this in a minute. There you go. That'll do. Bloody dog. Victorian cup of this. I made them out of the original hot water cylinder out the house. So whether I can clean this one up really shiny, I'm not sure. As long as they do the job, eh? That's better. Get the neighbours shouting up the dog. Ah, the joys. Yeah, just that side looks a bit black. Might have a line across there. Move that side. Okay, nice and clean now. Just a bit of staining on that. Let's give that one a little bit more skew. I don't think that, well, I could if I rubbed through the copper. Then again, I could cut most of this off because it just it only touches around the very inside. And right, I'll explain why I did that. Right. Now the head I use isn't the head off the bike. The original head has a couple of cracks in it, and then I acquired this head. This head is actually earlier. Now, man has the dowels. These are the later rocker boxes. These are my original rocker boxes. Now these have dowels in. Now, if you notice, there's no dowels in here. Now, what happens? These rockers boxes don't quite fit. And they have a tendency to leave a tiniest gap here and here. And if you use a standard gasket, they actually piss out of there. The oil just leaks, obviously. That's what piss out means. So, now, the idea of them putting the dowels in was to stop this half of the paper gasket sliding out or vibrating out. So what I did on these gaskets, I made them big enough to bridge this gap. And also instead of the pins, I make them hook around the two head studs, like so. So they're a fairly good fit inside, but they're a crap fit on the outside. But I'm not bothered about the outside, really. And so when when I put my rockers on, they're actually fairly oil tight. This is why when I used to make my gaskets, I used to leave them a bit big. But yes, I didn't discover that until I'd made half a dozen gaskets and I just ended up with rocker box leaks. And then when I ended up, engineers blueing them. And then you can see where they actually fit and where they don't. I'll just see if we can focus in on it. Right, you can see a bit better on that one. You can see where it fits. And then there's a gap. Same there. Ideally them lines should join up, but they don't. So as I say, that was what I come up with, and that allows me to use this head, the early head, with the later rocker boxes. The head's just resting on. There's no O-rings in. I've taken the O-rings out of the push-rod tubes. It's got a head gasket in, and obviously it's flat and touching. Now, because there's no O-rings on, I can lift the push-rod tubes. I'm going to lift them to the top, and that's a guesstimate. Now, I used to use an O-ring in the bottom here before. I think I'm going to be able to use that thinner one out the gasket set. Now, as a guesstimate, I reckon I can use them too. Obviously, the O-ring's at the top, and that one in the bottom. And that'll squish up by a couple of thou, I would have thought. So I'm just going to give it a shot with them two. Yes, I reckon they'll go in nice. So as I say, the head's on with the gasket, no rings on the push-rod tubes, lift the push-rod tube, and you need that gap fill in there, basically. Now I reckon that is going to work. Yes, there must be a difference in the other set of barrels at the base. Well, hopefully we can see that. Just going to tighten by a few thou, squash them up. So that's good. I'm just going to try it at that. Time for the head to go on. Right, I'm just about to do this. Well, I have not. I've just bought some LED lights, little LED bulbs, and they're casting a hard shadow. So, they're cold. So that's great. I'm just going to put a piece of paper towel over them to diffuse the light. Yeah, that's definitely better. I'll just plug that on. Yes, that'll do. Right, I'm just going to prepare my push-rod tubes in my usual way. Start off, clean the grease, clean any oil out of them. Around the top. in the groove. Cricketing. Do a clean. Took a small dot of silicon, and I'm just going to not fill the groove, but put a coating in the groove. If it's not dog yap and it's sirens going. I'll cure for a minute or two. Siren must have heard me, it stopped. A cure for a minute. And then I want a bit just around that edge in there. And then gently squish that down there just a touch, and then leave the silicon sticking out a bit. Leave that one for a minute. I'm leaving about a half a millimetre of silicon, so I'm not squashing it right down. Yeah, just leave off for a second. About 5 or 10 minutes I'm going to leave that. Leave them, and then I'll put these ones in a minute. Right, what I've actually noticed with these is they're a very loose fit in the band. The big thick ones are the right size. Yeah, the big thick ones, they fit in. That's how I would expect them all to fit. But they certainly don't. So that's a bit iffy, but I have noticed these, when I've stretched them over the tapper block, they're a better fit, but they're certainly not tight. If I stretch them over the tapper block, which I haven't, you probably couldn't get the wedding bands over. Again, with this, I'm just going to, same thing, silicon. Through my fingers, and I'm just going to go around the edge. very little in the middle, just so they've got a coating on them. So they become sticky. Right. And because they're a bit slack in there still, I'm just going to put a bit round there as well. Just a bit inside of the band. Again, I don't want loads in, I just want a bit of a coating in there. I think these will rattle around, to tell the truth. Right, let's go to the bike. I think I just had a file edit on the back one. Right, yep, file edit on the back one. Right, luckily I've got the front one. Same thing, take the ring. Take one of the wedding bands or rings. And just slide down there. Just make sure I haven't scraped any silicone around the followers or anything, or tappets. Right. Right, back here. I'm just taking a little more silicone and just pull it round the O-ring, really just to act as a lubricant. Right, the O-ring's in. And wipe that out. A little bit on the edge. Oh, the sleepy. Wipe that out. And then just a little bit around that edge. To make it sticky more than anything else. Right. Back to the bike. Right, head gasket. I want nothing on it. and this bits down fits into the groove. It's all nice and clean. Now give me head a wipe. I haven't touched my head, I haven't decorked it or nothing. Little gasket. And put the best bush of the tube to the front. And the one for the back. And I just hope these white plastic things are not too thick. Right. Come on. And now the head on. Line your push rod tubes up with the holes. Just give it a nice secure press. I think that'll be good. And I'm just going to start with centre bolt. And then the four Allen bolts. This is just to keep the head in the way, head gasket. My head has already recessed, but there's a recommendation of putting a bigger washer on, the same size as the washers on the outside. Right, they're about one finger tight then. Look. And the gap's closed up. I think them O-rings and that thing might just be work. Fingers crossed, if not, we'll piddle out. Yeah, right. Yeah, I sawed that ring key, that Allen key in half there. So I can use this one to tighten the centres with the rocker boxes on. 3/8, yeah. Just give me a final nip. I'm just going to put an extension bar onto my really short Allen key. They don't need to be mega tight, just tight. You can torque them up. One grunt tight. Click, click. Click, click. And here's my Allen key. What's that head on? Give it a couple of turnovers. Right, this will be that video. Next video, timing it up, put my rockers on. I would think.